for the gram. Bitches love the gram.
Oh, wait, shit.
Roxanne, Roxanne, all she wanna do is party all night. Goddamn, Roxanne, never gonna love me, but it's alright. She think I'm an asshole, she think I'm a player. She keep running back though, only cause I pay her. Roxanne, Roxanne, all she wanna do is party all night. Met her at a party in the hills, yeah. She just wanna do it for the thrill, yeah. Shorty drive a poodle with no top. But if I throw this money, she gonna drop.
Holy cow, has it been a minute since I've uploaded on this YouTube channel. So, today, I'm going to be attempting to add on to my first video in this series, I guess you could say, of how to improve your car control, which you can see right there. Now, I'm not like the best person for tutorials, I feel like, but some of them can be pretty good, some of them can be pretty horrible. So hopefully I can make this one short, simple, and easy to follow. I know you guys got places to be and got Rocket League to grind, so I'm not gonna make it too long, but hopefully I can actually give you guys something to learn off of. With that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and I hope I'll be back for more uploads soon. If not, just stay with me, guys. I'll be all right. And I appreciate you watching this far already, because you know you're kind of a G. And I'll catch you guys in the video. So one of the first things I like to tell people is to not really focus on the ball, but focus, yeah, that thing right there. Yeah, don't hit the thing. Ha, you thought. Oh, fuck. Yeah, so I basically mean to just don't hit the ball in free play. Go around the field like you see I'm doing right here and just flip. And get to know the way that your car moves around, because I have an Octane, so it's pretty common of how people use cars. So the way that I'm just trying to go around the field is just to wave dash and to flip as fast as I possibly can while landing on all four of my wheels, or jump into the crossbar and then landing on four of my wheels, or half flipping, anything you really want, just to get to know your car. Like turn around, wave dash, anything really, and it can really, really help the way that you improve your ground control. And also make sure you have zero boost and don't do that. As far as aerial control, you need to turn on a limited boost for this one because you're actually gonna be flying around. So I know it's very old, but I love, and I mean I love, to just fly around and jump to the wall, jump to the ceiling, jump from goal line, and then land on the backboard like this while air rolling and then landing on our four wheels. I think the most key part to this is to be able to air roll while you're flying, which is very easy, but knowing how to orient your car so that you land on all four wheels, boom, and then land on all four wheels on the ground too. Like, it's a very common thing to just go off in the ceiling and then jump, go to the crossbar, you know, like in free play, you see people doing it all the time, but they don't necessarily focus on it. If you focus really hard on just trying to hit the crossbar, try to jump from wall to wall, land on our four wheels, you'll have very good success in improving. So I know a lot of you guys right now are saying, oh my god, Jake, why are we only in free play? What the heck? By the way, I hope you guys like that voice. My answer to that is it really does make the most sense. If you really, really, really think about it, which I know is very hard to do nowadays for people, but doing training packs that are rinse and repeat, muscle memory only, just for basically no reason trying to get 100% of them, just doesn't make sense. And I know I contradict myself when I'm talking about my other car control video, because I do recommend training packs, but I do disagree with that now, because I found out a different way of improving. And my two cents to this is, if you think about it this way, warming up in free play and going around the field, jumping from wall to wall, jumping from ceiling to ceiling, anything like that. Okay, ceiling to ceiling doesn't make sense. I know, I'm gonna get called out for that. But you know what I mean. Going around the free play, forgetting about the ball, just going around, learning how to adapt your car, learning how to adapt for different situations, learning how to adapt for pretty much everything is so much better than sitting in a training prac doing the exact same shot and learning only how to do that exact same shot 10 times in a row. The only reason why I'm showing you guys a training pack, by the way, is just because the shots are cool and they look good for me to talking over, so yeah. But I still completely disagree with them. They're still fun, but yeah, just keep listening. That has absolutely no help to when there's actually cars on the field and when there's actually situations where you need to adapt. So it's kind of all a mentality thing and just the way that you look at it. And honestly, the easiest way to improve, in my opinion, you just go around free play doing different things, trying to improve your speed by wave dashing and flip canceling and all this stuff. Oh, by the way, I have a flip cancel video if you guys want to go see that right there. Yeah, easy plug. But it's really simple, and that's all I have to say. So I'm going to go wrap the video now, guys. I hope you guys have enjoyed the video so far. If you want to leave, I understand you. I love you, and I'll see you guys when I wrap the video up. So to wrap the video up, let's go over a little recap of what we have talked about. So, number one, going around the map, practicing wave dashing, going around the map, practicing pretty much anything you want as far as it's flip canceling, going around as fast as you can, flipping, understanding how your car works, and not just focusing on the ball. Number two, same exact mentality, but bring it to the air. Air rolling around the field, flying from backboard to backboard, flying to crossboard to ceiling, anything you really want. As long as you're not focusing on the ball, you're focusing on just your car and how fast you're going and trying to perfectly control it. And for you big boys out there, the GCs, which I know there's probably not too many of you guys watching because no one wants to watch me if they're a GC, but if you do, then, or even if you're a little lower than GC, you know, bringing the ball with you could be something challenging. As you can see here, I'm not trying to score, I'm trying to bring the ball around the map with me, I'm trying to wave dash with it, I'm trying to aerial with it, I'm just trying to keep the ball as close as possible to me while not trying to score. I'm just trying to control my car and the ball at the exact same time without trying to score, because I'm not trying to score, I'm trying to learn to improve my car control, I'm trying to learn to improve the way that I bring the ball around the pitch. But that's pretty much about it, guys. I mean, I appreciate you watching this far. If you've came it this far, let me know what your favorite color is in the comment section below. So I'm hoping to see a lot of greens out there. And if you also came this far, I don't know, I love you. Yeah. So I'm going to show you guys this whole compilation of some more goals and my new favorite song. So hopefully I don't get copyrighted for it because I haven't looked it up if it's copyrighted or not. But I'll make sure to give them credit. I love you guys and peace out.
And she laugh at you, Malibu, Malibu. Spending daddy's money with an attitude. Roxanne, Roxanne, Roxanne. All she wanna do is party all night. Goddamn, Roxanne. Never gonna love me, but it's alright. She think I'm an asshole. She think I'm a player. She keep running back.